Let's hear it, fans, for the defensive stars of your San Francisco 49ers. At defensive end from Missouri, number 94, Justin Smith. And at middle linebacker from Mississippi, number 52, Patrick Willis.
Day here in the city by the bay. Welcome to San Francisco, California at Candlestick Park. Happy to have you alongside to what should be a fantastic football showcase. The 49ers
are hosting here and want to be able to keep the home field advantage going as we get ready for this one. Chris, what is the key in this matchup?
Well, Gus, I think you said it best, home field advantage. This team needs to come out and rally early to get the fans on their side. If you have thousands of fans screaming and cheering, you feed off of that and you can turn it into some positive stuff on the field, this should be a great game in this one.
All right, Chris, with that in mind, it's game time, and we've got two teams really ready to rumble. Leckler is ready to kick this one downfield and get this game started. He'll down it in the end zone.
He played high school football in San Diego with running back Reggie Bush.
They'll go to work at the 20-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Looks left. Here's a short pass.
The focus of this offense is ball control, and it's built from the offensive line up. Of course, when you have one of the premier running backs in Frank Gore from Miami, it becomes an easy decision to run the rock.
No question about that, Gus. Frank Gore is one of those running backs, maybe not as flashy as some guys, but he puts up flashy numbers. It seems like he gains 5 yards falling down, and he is just built so low to the ground, the guys hate tackling him.
And Chris, he is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one.
All right, let's meet the starters on defense. And it's a unit led by cornerback Nnamdi Asamoah from Cal, who was a cerebral football player, and you love to see these guys.
Yeah, definitely intelligent, thoughtful on the field. You can see that very little gets by him, but physically, he is just one of the most talented guys in the game right now. I don't believe much in the term shutdown corner, but it still applies to Nnamdi Asamoah.
Looks for the safe short throw. Rolando McClain was there for the stop.
The play started with an excellent fake by the quarterback. He really sold the run, and he never gave the defense a chance to get back into position.
Flips it out short to his left. And he's tackled at about the 43-yard line by Johnson.
Good job all the way around by the defense that time. Not only did they have the deep routes completely covered there, but they also had the check down well within their grasp.
The give to the tailback. Michael Huff was there to bring him down.
And when you can run the ball for first downs, it sets up the play action. Now look for this team to be able to mix it up, and that can be so tough on the defense.
Daylight! And the tackle was made by Cameron Wembley. A nice pickup of 8 yards. And 2 yards away here on second down. They give it off here. He's dropped down right around the 26-yard line by Branch. And we'll have a first down and 10. Ball sitting at the 26-yard line.
lost it. Oakland got it. He's got room. There he goes. Rumble, young man, rumble. Touchdown, silver and black.
The scoop, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown. I don't think anybody was going to have a chance to catch him there.
The Raiders get into the end zone first. Janikowski adds the extra point. Oakland is up a touchdown. Oakland gets ready to kick it away. Ginn stands back to field the kick. This will be down to the end zone for a touchback. It was a tough series last time out, giving up the fumble and the touchdown on the same play. Will they bounce back here? The offense will take over at the 20. First down and 10. Hunter on the right side. The stop was made by Jarvis Moss.
7-yard gain on the play.
Second down, and they're going to need just about 3 yards to pick up the first. Hunter takes the give. Daylight.
Pretty impressive stuff. As a back, you have to just keep slamming it in there, believing that hole is going to be there eventually. That time it was, and he took advantage.
So it's first down and 10 after the big run. Throws it over the middle of the field. He's tackled around the 28-yard line by Brown. That'll bring up second down, a couple of yards needed to convert. Looking. Fires it to the left.
The pass falls incomplete.
Good release that time by the receiver at the line of scrimmage, but the pass simply was just not there.
Third and short situation now. They'll need a couple of yards to convert. Passes out to his right.
And the defense came after him with the blitz, and you see the net result of that. You don't always get a sack, but sometimes if you can just rush the quarterback, it is a positive net result for the defense.
The kick is no good.
The kick is no good.
It's first and 10. They're on their own 35. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Shante Spencer was there for the stop. From their own 40-yard line. Gives it up the gut. He's wrestled down around the 47-yard line by Supuaga. From their own 47-yard line. McFadden on the give. Shante Spencer was there to bring him down.
Gain of 4 on the play.
Second down and 5 to go. Wait, He needs to get rid of it. Takes a handoff and tackled immediately.
Tough situation for the offense after the sack. They're going to need a long 13 to convert.
Still looking for an open man. It's tipped away. Great defense.
And the pass will fall incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
I don't know if that's the guy I want to pick on third down when you have to have a conversion. He is tough.
They'll start this drive at the 20-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. And the tackle was made by Rolando McClain.
Number 21, the ball carrier. No gain.
It's now second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Going down the middle with it.
Number 11.
Third down coming up after that incompletion.
Let's go.
He rolls out to his right. He goes down. Sack.
He gets the sack, and the offensive lineman didn't have much of a chance.
Yeah, he delivered a perfect swim move, and he was into the backfield in a flash. That's a kind of his signature move, if you will, and he's had a lot of success using it to get to the quarterback.
And it didn't look like the quarterback even saw him coming.
Yeah, he gets back there so fast that even if you have quick reaction time, you're still going to get sacked.
He gets out to about the 42-yard line. Aldon Smith was there for the stop. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. On the ground, left side.
And as we look at the key players on offense, leading the way is versatile running back Darren McFadden out of Arkansas. He is a physical specimen.
Yeah, you don't always think of a guy that big running as fast as Darren McFadden does. Plus, he has a little wrinkle to his game. He's pretty good throwing the ball, so you always have to be on your toes as a defense.
And Chris, he is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one.
Stiff arms, and he's brought down.
And as we take some time to introduce the defensive key players, we spotlight Patrick Willis from Ole Miss. He is one of the best linebackers in the NFL, and he's getting better.
Yeah, multiple Pro Bowls in his career says an awful lot about Patrick Willis. He has a motor that never stops running, and he has become the emotional leader of this defense. And it's not very often that I get really excited about defensive line play, but that time, the guys up front on defense were just overpowering.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is good. He really came through on the long-distance attempt.
You don't make a kick like that without a perfect hold and a perfect snap. But let's give this kicker some credit. That was an extraordinary effort.
He'll down it in the end zone. They couldn't do anything against this defense on their last drive, and they were forced to punt it away. They'll start at the 20. And we'll have a first down and 10. Smith tosses to the left side. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Michael Huff was there to bring him down. Second down and 9. Ball on their own 21. Smith with the give. Stiff arms, and the defender still makes the tackle.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action, and there's almost no way to stop an offense if you can't stop the run and you have to deal with play action.
First down and 10. And looks left. Throws. It's intercepted. The stop was made by Ted Ginn.
Well, so much for the theory that defensive backs can't catch. That was really a nice catch on that one.
It's first and 10. Ball's on the 41. Campbell, pitch right. And the tackle was made by Nate Clements. It's a gain of 4. They line up at the 37. He puts it on the ground. San Francisco falls on it, and they have the turnover.
Well, the number one rule for a halfback is you have to be able to hold on to the football. All the statistics show you turn it over, and you're going to lose.
They'll get the ball here at the 44-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Avoids a sack by getting it off as he's hit.
And the protection just has to be better, because right now this pressure is starting to get in the head of the quarterback. He's making some bad throws.
Smith hands it off straight ahead.
Number 21.
Hit and drop behind the line.
Loss of 4.
Third down. They'll need 14 to convert. The ball is on their own 40. Going deep toward the left sideline. And the pass falls incomplete. And that will be a 3-and-out for the offense after that incompletion.
And it really looked like the defense won the battle up front. The big guys controlling the line of scrimmage made the difference there.
On attempt, out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 25. Good coverage downfield.
Jason Campbell really let that one go. He's definitely got the arm strength to make those kinds of throws, and everybody knows that, but accuracy is still the key to winning in this game.
Looking over the middle. He's going deep. Intercepted. He's brought down at about the 37-yard line by Miller. And we'll have a first down and 10.
Red
rolling out to his right. Thomas Howard was there for the stop.
The quarterback found his man there and picks up a big gain through the air. Chris, how did he get open on that play?
Well, Gus, this guy is known for being a ball hog, but sometimes if a defensive back tries to make a play on the ball, he'll come up short and leave his receiver open for a big gain, and I think that's exactly what we saw there.
It'll be interesting to see how he plays him for the rest of the game.
They have it at the 40. It's a quarterback sack. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. Our score here, 10-0. Welcome back to San Francisco. Third down and 12 to go.
Let's go.
And they got him.
Effective blitzing can really destroy an offensive game plan because you're so used to having time to develop plays down the field. Now you come with a good blitz and the quarterback just doesn't have time to get it off.
Well, their offense will now come onto the field in excellent position, already leading in this game. First down and 10. Campbell pitches out to the right. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. Patrick Willis was there to bring him down.
The defense makes a great hit, forces the fumble, but you know the coach will tell him that he has to hang on to the ball.
You got it, Gus. No coach wants to see his player ever fumble. And to be honest, the quickest way to get knocked out of the NFL is to keep giving up the football. You simply cannot do it.
It's almost picked off. Miller was the intended receiver on the play. Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 15. Looking for a man. Steps up, and he's quickly sacked.
So he goes down again. The defense is making their way into the backfield and getting to the quarterback. Chris, what can he do here to turn this around?
Well, Gus, you know, this guy can move. He isn't strictly a pocket passer, so look for him to try to scramble out of the pocket and try to make something happen with his feet.
Ginn fields it at the 40. Takes this one out to the 46. Rose was there for the stop.
He was just a couple of steps away from breaking that one all the way. This coverage team better start stepping up or he's going to take one in for six.
It's first and 10. Gore gets it on the draw.
And so many times you hear offensive coordinators criticized because they don't try to run the football enough. Well, when you get stuffed in the backfield like that, you understand why they would rather call the pass play.
Smith will hand it off. He doesn't get back to the line.
There are just some guys in this league that you have to run away from. But the danger in that is you run away from him and he uses his speed to catch you from behind.
It brings up third and long. They'll need 15. Ball at midfield. Gore on the delay. Richard Seymour was there to bring him down. The coaches have to be disappointed with that effort.
Yeah, their poor defense didn't even have time to go over and get a glass of water. All of a sudden, the punter's back on the field, and the defense has to go play again.
It's fourth down. The 49ers are lining up to punt this one away. And they already have the lead. This field position could set them up to put even more points on the board. They'll take over at the 20-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. They tackle him for a loss.
Sure doesn't look like he's running with the same explosiveness that we usually see out of him.
Yeah, and I think that fumble he had earlier has changed his approach. You can see him really trying to cover up the ball more, and you can't run like that in the NFL.
Searching for an open man. Sapuaga records his first sack of the season. Looking at third and long now after the sack. Reese on the handoff. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. Patrick Willis was there for the stop. So, it's fourth down. The Raiders line up to punt. And he calls for the fair catch at the 41-yard line. And this is a great opportunity to get back into this ball game. This offense needs to put a nice drive together right now. He's looking over the top. Crabtree was his intended target.
The intended target. Second down.
Second down and 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 41. Let's it go deep. Nearly picked off. He should have had that one. No completion that time, and it'll bring up third down. Is out to his right. The defender bats it away. The defender gets a hand on it, and that will bring up fourth down.
And those are the kind of big third down plays you have to have on defense to get the ball back and give your team a chance on offense.
And it's in the end zone for a touchback. They'll set up shop at the 20. First down, 10 to go. Fakes the handoff and scans the field. It's a pick! The stop was made by Jacoby Ford. The 49ers get their second interception of the first half. And we'll have a first down and 10. Steps and throws to the left side. It's picked! The Raiders' defense has come up with two big picks now in the first half. First down and 10. Takeo Spikes was there to bring him down.
Number 45 gets the call. Gain of one.
It's second down and 9 to go. Passes out to the left. Shante Spencer was there for the stop.
And that was a little hum baby coming out of there from the quarterback. We've all heard about how strong his arm is, and we saw it there.
From their own 47-yard line. He needs to get rid of it. Takes a handoff and tackles immediately. It's now second and long following the sack. McFadden on the inside handoff.
Gets the ball on the run. Gain of 11.
And third down now. They'll need seven to convert. Ball at midfield. McFadden on the draw.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
It's fourth down. The Raiders lining up to punt. He muffed the punt at the 10.
How many times have we seen this happen in the past? A guy takes his eyes off the ball, trying to see what's happening in front of him. The guy's coming down to make the tackle. Take your eyes off of it just for a second, and you lose it.
Well, I'm sure the next time he gets a chance, he'll try to make up for that one. They hand it off. Four yards will get them in for the score. They'll give it off here. He's tackled right around the 2-yard line by Goldson. He's off to the back, and he's in.
No need to give it to a fullback down here on the goal line with this team when they've got a halfback that can cram it in there like that.
And he adds the point after. Leckler will be kicking off. Johnson stands back to field the kick. This will be down to the end zone for a touchback.
The 49ers are in a dangerous territory right now. This one's gotten a little out of hand, but a touchdown on this series, maybe your defense gets a little momentum going.
Has a man to his right. And the tackle was made by Rolando McClain.
The 49ers have a bunch of short completions, but they're not getting the yards after the catch right now, and that's because the defense is playing them very tight and making good, solid tackles.
Gore on the give.
hammered in the backfield.
So many times it's up to that backside blocker to get his guy on the ground, and it sounds ugly, but typically those guys are chopping at their knees and trying to knock them off their feet so there's some cutback lanes.
He's dropped, and that's a huge sack.
Number 11, taken down for a sack. 7-yard loss on the play.
Fields the ball at the 34. They really did a good job keeping him contained on that one.
Yeah, he really didn't have much of a chance at all to make anything happen there. I mean, I know this guy's a dangerous punt return guy, but you can't do it on your own.
Bush, the ball carrier.
The ball carrier
gets maybe a couple.
Gain of two.
Here's the give. And he's tackled around the 39-yard line by Supuaga.
He's searching for a receiver. He tipped the ball away. And the pass was knocked away at the last minute.
Just terrific play by the defense. They followed the quarterback's eyes, made a quick jump on the ball, and were all over that one.
He will start from the 13. He takes it back to the 29-yard line. DeMarcus Van Dyke was there to bring him down.
He did a good job there finding a seam and getting up the field. You know, a lot of people don't realize that being a punt returner or a kick returner is one of the toughest jobs in the NFL. There's a whole lot of things that could go wrong and only a few that can really go right.
Crabtree was the intended receiver.
Second down.
He's going deep with it.
Crabtree was the intended receiver on the play.
Just gets it away.
Michael Crabtree was his intended target.
Yeah, it wasn't close because the big guy was giving him a whack just as he let that one go. He was really under some pressure that time.
Ford will take it at the 21. And they're already up big. That return just really puts them into position to make this thing a blowout. Still looking for an open man. He's brought down around the 43-yard line by Goldson. Good coverage downfield. Brings in another one.
Number 18.
He's wrestled down at about the 35-yard line by Smith. Bush gets the ball.
That was because the defense filled up all the gaps. The back was looking for somewhere to run, but by bringing the run blitz, they took away all the holes and stopped them for a minimal gain.
Here's a halfback. The stop was made by TKO. Gets about four on the play. Flips it out short to his left. It's intercepted. And he's running with a purpose now. Watch out!
Not only was that a tremendous interception, but when he got the ball in his hand, he looked like he knew what to do with it. What a run.
So with that, they took advantage of the interception and added points to the board. Joe Nedney tacks on the extra point. San Francisco is just about ready to kick this one away. Higgins is back to receive the kick. Takeo Spikes was there for the stop.
You have to like the effort there, but he would have been better off taking a vacation day and just staying in the end zone on that one.
Goes through his progression. Has it on the sideline, but was he inbounds? The officials will huddle. Yes, he did make the catch.
Great hands, great footwork. That was really well done.
Looking for a man. Passes it deep on the left side. He's looking towards the left side. It'll be fourth down following the pass deflection.
I don't know if that's the guy I want to pick on third down when you have to have a conversion. He is tough.
Fields the ball at the 30. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Johnson was there to bring him down. Has a seam down the middle. He's dropped down at about the 43-yard line by Branch. Dumps it short.
And the defense came after him with the blitz, and you see the net result of that. You don't always get a sack, but sometimes if you can just rush the quarterback, it is a positive net result for the defense.
Flips it out short. He's tackled right around the 26-yard line by Shaughnessy. In heavy traffic.
How many times do you see a team perfectly execute a blitz pickup and simply can't block the guy? And there's nothing the coaches can do there. They did their job, but the guys just got overwhelmed.
Searching for an open man. That'll be it for the first half of play. The score is 17-7. Back to San Francisco. As both teams take the field, we're just about ready for the second half kickoff. Aldon Smith was there for the stop. To about the 21-yard line. Patrick Willis was there to bring him down.
Gain of two on the play.
Get ready. On the ground with the tailback. He tries to spin, but he's brought down. 4 yards on that play. Again with the run. And the tackle was made by Navarro Bowman. Excellent run, and he moves the chains. The give to the tailback. He gets to about the 32-yard line. Taylor Mays was there for the stop. Surveys the field. It is an incomplete pass.
Number five can't complete the pass.
Short throw to the right. And he's able to hold on to it. They lose a yard with that pass.
You know, sometimes as a quarterback, you have to be careful about dumping it down too quickly. Stand in there, see what you've got working down the field. That time they were all over that quick throw.
And there's the flag, and we're going to have our first penalty.
Holding by the receiving
Tonga
team.
Was there to bring him down. And this one looks like it's going to come back.
First down.
Boy, it's tough enough to try and stop an NFL offense, but when you give them extra chances, it is almost impossible.
A lot of movement down there on the offensive line.
First down.
Well, that's more than a little humiliating for an offensive lineman. Unfortunately, there's nowhere to hide after one of those. And, yeah, they know national television is going to be talking about them as well.
Looking to his left. He's going deep. Deflected and broken up. Number 17 was the intended receiver. Hands it off. The stop was made by Lamar Houston. 4 yards on the carry.
On the play. Gain of 4 on the play.
Looking for a big gain down the middle.
The Raiders did an excellent job tackling and keeping things in front of them on that series to force the 3-and-out.
Tackle was made by Michael Crabtree. He really didn't have any room to work on that punt return.
Boy, he hardly had any room to do anything there. They've got to come up with a better scheme or some better blockers or something. This guy's a good punt returner. He's just not getting any help at all from his teammates.
Bush takes the give. The stop was made by Ray McDonald.
Boy, anytime this back gets a chance to see things develop in front of him and get a little momentum going, he is so effective. That time the lane was there, he shot right through there and picked up a big first down.
Bush will run it again. Willis has been on a collision course with the ball carriers. That takedown marking his 5th tackle. A burst of speed, and he's in the open.
Personal foul, face mask, defense. First down.
And so the defense gives up some yards after the flag.
Gus, everybody knows that football is a game of emotion, but unchecked emotion is a bad thing. You have to be able to control yourself on the football field. That's a big mistake.
Patrick Willis was there for the stop.
Yeah, the offensive line did their job. They created enough of a seam to get him up into the secondary, and then he was able to explode from there.
They're going to pitch it. He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
If you want to be considered one of the top cornerbacks in the National Football League, everybody has to be able to cover. But the top guys can not only cover, but come up and make big hits like that. Tremendous play.
Play action. He's got time. It's tipped and falls incomplete.
Well, you have to admire his courage. He's not afraid to make any throw, anytime, anywhere, but he's lucky that one wasn't picked off.
Jones gets the carry. Gets to about the 5-yard line. Manny Lawson was there to bring him down. And looks left. Throws. Looks like he made the catch, but there's no signal yet. They're saying no score on the play. steps and throws to the left side. Number 17 was the intended receiver on the play. Hunter on the give.
And you love to see those linebackers playing downhill like that. Not just flowing sideline to sideline, but attacking and trying to get in the backfield.
He fights forward to about the 7. John Henderson was there for the stop. Signals for the fair catch.
At the 42-yard line.
He's searching for a receiver.
But we need to stand right here.
And he's tackled right around the 22-yard line by Culliver. And so far in this one, as you can see, this player has been the impact performer of the game so far. Still looking for an open man. Catches it one-handed. Navarro Bowman was there to bring him down. Bush gained 7 yards with the catch. Short throw to the left. Into traffic, and it's picked off. And he'll lose yardage on the play.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Makes the throw over the middle. He's brought down around the 38-yard line by Mitchell. Throws to his left. It's picked off. He's wrestled down at about the 41 by Sims. Good coverage downfield. And the tackle was made by Nate Clements.
Handoff up the middle.
He's dropped down around the 13-yard line by McKillop.
They hand it off. He's tackled around the 5-yard line by Brock.
Gain of 7.
They'll get the call again.
Well, you know you've got an aggressive safety when he's making tackles for a loss behind the line of scrimmage. Typically, these guys are trying to not give up a big play in the passing game. Now, when you see somebody in the backfield, that's impressive.
He's going to be tackled for a loss.
You know, you can draw up any sort of protection scheme or blocking scheme that you want. But ultimately, this game comes down to one big man against another big man. And that time, the defense's big men, they won the battle.
The kick is good. So the score now, the Raiders 20, the 49ers 7. Sebastian Janikowski will be kicking off. Johnson stands back to field the kick. This will be down to the end zone for a touchback. The 49ers turn the ball over on an interception their last time out. Hunter on the run. And he's tackled around the 23-yard line by Brown. Hunter, left side. He's brought down right around the 26-yard line by Powers. Has a man short to his left. He's wrestled down around the 34-yard line by Mitchell. And that'll bring this quarter to an end, and our score is 20-7. Welcome back to San Francisco. The 49ers start this final quarter with the football. They'll be looking for a quick score.
Ohio! Ohio!
Looking for the screen. He's dropped down at about the 49-yard line. By Grove. Gets it on the inside. He's tackled around the 43-yard line by number 31. Opts for a short throw.
And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line by Brown. Searching for an open man. Looking. Fires it to the left.
A missed chance to make a big play there. He seemed to get a little too excited and just made a really poor throw.
He's looking towards the left side. He can't come up with it. Incomplete pass. Walker was his intended target. Was knocked away at the last minute.
And those are the kind of big third down plays you have to have on defense to get the ball back and give your team a chance on offense.
The kick is no good. He hooked it left. Jumps it out right. And the pass falls incomplete.
Number 83, the intended receiver on the play. Second down.
Bush on the inside handoff. Rumble, young man, rumble. He cruises in for the touchdown.
And big plays mean big ticket sales. That's exactly the kind of plays that NFL fans pay their money to come see.
Point after is good. So, with over 13 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score, the Raiders, 27, the 49ers, 7. Sebastian Janikowski looks ready to kick it away. Williams is deep, looking to return the kickoff.
Kickoff return for Lost Raiders.
Run, right side. He's brought down around the 25-yard line by number 31. Short pass to his left.
And I'm sure from the tight end's version of the facts, he was just simply too fast on that play. The ball couldn't catch up to him.
He didn't get back to the line.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive linemen to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
A on the return. It's loose. And they fall on a loose ball.
I just get the feeling he was trying to make too much happen out there. Sometimes you just get the ball, get what you can, and get on the ground. You cannot afford to cough it up there.
Smith flips it out. He's wrestled down around the 45-yard line by Brown. Throws deep towards the left. Intercepted. The Raiders have now picked off four passes in this ballgame. Gradkowski hands it off straight ahead.
And you love to see those linebackers playing downhill like that. Not just flowing sideline to sideline, but attacking and trying to get in the backfield.
Bush off the left side. There he goes! Burst of speed. Boom! He's gone. Touchdown. They keep pouring it on. Touchdown. So after the pick, the defense puts up points on this possession. Extra point is good. In the fourth, with more than 11 minutes remaining, the score is the Raiders 34, the 49ers 7. Sebastian Janikowski is just about ready to kick this one away. Williams is back to receive the kick. He'll down it in the end zone.
Down to the end zone. He'll start this drive at the 20.
Ohio.
Passes short right side. The stop was made by Cameron Wembley. Miller picks up about 3 with the catch. Fires a laser down the middle. He's dropped down at about the 31 by Powers. Smith will hand it off. Cuts back and he's dropped.
Well, let's face it, defensive players get paid for sacks. They were really coming after the quarterback that time, and the delay caught him napping.
Has a man to his right. Second down for the offense after that incomplete pass.
Lucy, Lucy.
Smith hands it off. John Henderson was there for the stop. Passing in this situation seems like it would have been a good idea.
Passing in every situation seems to me like it would be a better idea, but when you have the clock working against you like this, it's time to put it up.
Short throw to the right.
The pass is
Davis was the intended receiver.
The intended target. Fourth down.
He's searching for a receiver. He's tackled around the 44-yard line by Brown. Bush on the handoff. And he's tackled around the 47-yard line by McKillop. Dumps it out left.
Intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Surveys the field.
Yeah, he just rushed that throw that time. He had a guy wide open. I don't know why he tried to get the ball out of there so quickly.
Goes into the end zone for a touchback. And as their offense comes onto the field, what are you looking for them to do? Passes out to his right. It is an incomplete pass. Long was the intended receiver on the play.
Second down.
Feeds it to the back. He's brought down right around the 22-yard line by Williams.
Two on the play.
Dumps it out right.
Number one.
So we'll probably see the punt team now after that incompletion as the offense goes three and out.
Yeah, they just kind of looked out of sync from the very beginning there, and I thought first down really set the tone for that entire series.
Aldon Smith was there to bring him down. He got everything he could, but there really wasn't much room.
Yeah, that certainly wasn't one of his best efforts there. Maybe if he would have gotten a little more help from his blockers, he could have broken one out of there. You know, sometimes it just takes one good block to create a seam to get one up the field.
Bush takes it up the middle.
Number 29 gets the call.
He's wrestled down around the 48-yard line by Brown. Cartwright gets the carry. He's dropped down at about the 45-yard line by number 95. Down behind the line. What about that play call?
Well, I always like to see an offense stay aggressive, I guess. But at least in this situation, it's a fourth quarter. You have the lead. I can understand the call.
Catches it, and they get him. So, Chris, what does this offense have to do to get them back into this game? Flips it out short. Long. Picked up six with that grab. Inside give. He doesn't get back to the line.
So many times it's up to that backside blocker to get his guy on the ground, and it sounds ugly, but typically those guys are chopping at their knees and trying to knock them off their feet so there's some cutback lanes.
Passes it short, and the pass is incomplete. Number one. Fourth down now after the incomplete pass. The offense wasn't able to get on track during the last series.
There's nothing more frustrating for an offense to come in and go three and out. That's just embarrassing.
Signals for the fair catch at the 43-yard line. Radkowski gives it up the middle. Not much, maybe 2 yards on the carry.
Gain of two.
Get ready. Red 38. Red 38.
He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage.
Did you see how fast that linebacker was on that one? Not only did he recognize it, but when he did recognize it, he had the explosiveness to get there.
Bush takes a handoff. Makes it out to about the 49. Patrick Willis was there for the stop. Keep it on the ground again. He's tackled around the 45-yard line by Evans. Bush gets the call. 2 yards.
The defense filled up all the gaps. The back was looking for somewhere to run, but by bringing the run blitz, they took away all the holes and stopped them for a minimal gain.
They go with the run. And he's tackled at about the 33-yard line by Evans. It's loose. San Francisco has the football. Breaks a tackle, and he's loose. And he's running with a purpose now. And he's gone. He's in. Touchdown.
Do you know how hard it is to scoop up one of those loose fumbles on the run, maintain possession, and get it in the end zone? What a great athletic play. Man, that is just pure speed. And when you have jets like that, it really throws a bit of fear into a defense because they know you have the ability to make a play from anywhere on the field.
Point after is good. Number 2 is ready to kick this one off. Higgins stands back to field the kick. Camps under it. He will start from his own 5. He makes it back to the 25. Patrick Willis was there to bring him down. And he'll just kneel it here. That'll do it from the field. We have top plays and stats coming up next, so stay right with us. And let's take a look at the Gatorade Performer of the Game.